फॉर मी सिंस आई एम फ्रॉम अ नॉन आईटी बैकग्राउंड, मेरा बैकग्राउंड वो था कि फॉर मी स्ट्रिंग यूज्ड टू बी अ धागा, मेरे लिए स्ट्रिंग का मतलब धागा था. लेटर ऑन आई गॉट टू नो दैट स्ट्रिंग इज बेसिकली एन एरे ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स. आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट इफ आई फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल बैकग्राउंड, जिसके लिए स्ट्रिंग का मतलब था धागा, मैं कर सकता हूँ तो यार कोई भी कर सकता है. इट्स टोटली टोटली फीजिबल, टोटली नॉर्मल, एंड यू शुड गो फॉर इट.
Hello, hi Bikramjeet, how are you?
Hi Gloria, I'm good, how are you?
I'm doing well too. Thank you for joining today's success story. Let's get started with a quick introduction from you.
So, as you know, my name is Bikramjeet Singh. I'm a mechanical engineering graduate. I have a little bit of sales experience in as a BDA, Business Development Associate. I also prepared for GATE in mechanical field only.
Okay.
And later on, I realized to switch my careers and pivot into software engineering. So a friend of mine suggested that you should go for Programming Pathshala, and here I am.
Okay, nice. Can you tell me about a little about where you are placed right now, what position you've gotten, and where did that come into play?
So I'm currently at a designation of software engineer.
Okay.
The name of the organization is ZRPL. Zeitgeist Retail Private Limited.
Okay.
It's a small startup consisting of around 30-35 people.
Okay.
And it's based out of Bangalore only. Currently have only one office. So I am basically working on some integrations and APIs and some sort of DSAs. That is what I'm working on currently.
All
software
right.
engineer, basically. Yeah.
Understood. Got it. Congratulations on getting this job. Tell me a little about, you know, how was your preparation journey? When did you plan on starting studying? So, and you coming from a sales background, what was the motivation and, you know, get going into the tech side? Where did that come from?
So definitely I wanted to switch my careers and wanted to get into the tech industry. But I was very oblivious as to what is to be done properly. So a friend of mine who is from IIT Bhubaneswar, he told me that you should opt for Programming Pathshala. He knew about Programming Pathshala since its inception. And he was friends with the founders, Anup Bhaiya and Vivek Bhaiya as well. So okay. He told me that you should not wander here and there, and you should straight away go with the DSA course that Programming Pathshala is offering. Okay. And he's at a very good place and earning a good salary. So I thought, and he is also a good friend of mine. So I thought it's better to go with Programming Pathshala. I started it's been 2 years that I have been associated with Programming Pathshala. I started doing DSA like 2 years back. So for me, since I am from a non-IT background, mera background wo tha ki for me, string used to be a dhaga. Mere liye string ka matlab dhaga tha. Later on, I got to know that string is basically an array of characters. I would like to say that if I, from mechanical background, jiske liye string ka matlab tha dhaga, so main kar sakta ho to yaar koi bhi kar sakta. It's totally, totally feasible, totally normal. And you should go for it. I was grinding the questions, watching tutorials, then doing the questions as the program suggests, basically. I had never opted for anything else, only Programming Pathshala, and that's it. Never watched any other YouTube. Basically did what my friend said, straight away, go with the program and don't waste time.
Got it. Understood. So you had a 2-year journey in total, correct? From when you started your preparation to when you landed a job.
Yes, yes,
okay.
Yes.
Can you walk me through now and shed some light on, you know, what were the difficulties that you faced? So I'm pretty sure 2 years felt really long and there was a lot of hard work and dedication coming from you. So what were the difficulties and challenges that you personally faced?
Honestly, I took 2 years. I think anybody can do it in like 6 months to 1 year. I took so long because I was not sure how much preparation is enough. So that was a fault on my part. It can be done in like 6 months to 1 year. So okay. I was not feeling very confident, although I have like 24,000 points on the dashboard, PPA dashboard.
Okay. Yeah,
so
yeah.
I think that's a decent score. But still, I was not sure whether I should. I was scared basically to apply, to be honest. So when I had just started applying, I asked Anup Bhaiya, what should I do? And he said, you should apply, start applying. And then I got the motivation and started applying. One day I randomly had a got a call from the HR of my current organization, ZRPL. Okay. When the whole interview process was done, then I realized that I have been referred by Anoop Bhaiya.
Okay.
And then only the CTO of the company told me that you've been referred by him. I also didn't have any idea that Anoop Bhaiya referred me. He didn't even tell me and still referred me.
Okay.
So, yeah.
That's nice. All right. So, okay, interesting story. Can you tell us a little bit more about how this interview journey was for you since, you know, the first interview, what kind of questions were thrown at you? Yeah, and how many rounds were there and all of that?
As far as I can remember, there were four rounds, basically. First, the HR call was very simple, basic HR questions that you ask. What is your current educational background? Where are you from? Just to get to know. Very basic HR round. The second round was somewhat technical. So they asked me a few, not very hard, not even medium. The questions were somewhat easy, like only 2-3 questions of DSA. I would say, considering the programming Pathshala's dashboard, the questions were pretty easy for me, at least.
Okay.
So I cleared that. And after that, one more round with my hiring manager. First was the HR round, then second was the managerial round, but manager was not present at that time. So company CTO took the round. After the CTO round, there was my manager round, engineering managers round. So once I was done with the CTO, he didn't deep dive. So I think my feedback from the CTO was good enough. So he asked very basic questions. Questions related to the web infrastructure. What are APIs? What is front end, back end? How does the API work? Basically, the flow of the web architecture.
Okay.
So that I was easily able to communicate. And after that, the round was the director round, which again was just to see the fitment, how will I able to adjust in the company's environment or not. Also, there was before the director, there was a director round, there was one more round that was, I think, with my product lead. That was more or less very cultural fitment round. And then after the director round happened. So four rounds, basically.
Understood. So in overall, you will call this, you know, an easy or mediocre process, interview process that you went through?
I would say it wasn't definitely an easy process, not considering the fact that the questions that we have done in the dashboard of Programming Pathshala.
It was easy.
The questions were not very easy, but in fact, somewhat easy for me.
It was just a long process, a little rigorous process, but it was easy for you and you were able to go through.
Yeah, rigorous in the sense like it took almost 20 days from the start till the end, the process. Okay. So definitely, yes. Somewhat not very rigorous, but yes, every five days I'm having an interview. So,
and you, before you got this or you landed or you started interviewing with them, you were giving interviews somewhere else as well?
Yeah, I had just started applying. I started to receive the calls from other organizations as well. One interview I was also able to crack, but considering the fact that I had a certain gap in my resume, so they were not very comfortable with that. So I said that is totally fine. So this was in fact my second interview. First interview I was able to clear. This was my second interview and I got placed.
Okay, that's nice.
I had just started applying, actually.
Got it. Understood. So now I think something that will be really helpful for the students will be, how were you able to manage your stress throughout the preparation? I mean, what kept you motivated and all of that?
So considering the fact that I am from a core engineering background, that is from mechanical background, I had absolutely zero knowledge of IT or software engineering. So the first module definitely helped me a lot. I had to learn from the very scratch in the sense that I didn't even know that what are the variables, what is a string, what is a other basic. No, data structures are a different ballgame. I didn't even know the basics. So module one definitely helped me a lot. Most of the people who are from software background will definitely skip the module one. But for people like me, it's a very good boon, I would say. So module one definitely helped. At times, I'll not lie, I felt demotivated. But since I had my friend, he told me that, the thing is, once you will have to learn this anyhow, whether you learn this on the job or even after, let's say, you quit the job and then you study, ultimately, you'll have to study. I came with that mindset that I'll have to work hard for once. So I thought, why not right now? So it's not like after I'm working, it'll be tough for me to study, you know, obviously. So I thought I'll work hard this time. So that's it. And definitely felt motivated. My friend was there to help me a lot. It's not like he was clearing my doubts regarding software engineering, but he was more on the emotional support part. So that was really helpful.
Understood. And were you getting any, you know, support from, you know, Anoop Bhaiya or Vivek Bhaiya? Did you get to receive any guidance there? Because you came from a non-tech experience background. Feel like you need a little bit more insight and where you, you know, your progress is going.
Yes. I definitely took help from Anoop Bhaiya. See, the thing is, when you come from a non-IT background, no, you are definitely very oblivious as to what is to be done, whether I should go watch this tutorial or whether I should, how many questions I have to solve. So when I was like, when I was done with preparation from my end, then I started consulting him. That was my bad. I should have consulted him long time back, but it's totally fine. And then he gave me the motivation that you should start applying. And then I started applying and luckily I got the job. So definitely Anoop Bhaiya helped me a lot in giving me the motivation. Yeah.
Understood. Got it. So a lot of people, you know, are trying to learn DSA at this time. What is the right strategy that, you know, Bikramjeet feels now to, you know, learn DSA that could, you know, help our students?
See, what I would recommend is not go after the clearing a certain number of questions and all.
Okay.
Get the fundamentals correct first. It's not about how many questions you solve. It's about the types and variety of questions that you have experience of. Okay. Let's say in a XYZ topic, there are, let's say, five types of questions. So you should know what are the five types of questions. More or less, the questions are the same. It's just some minor tweaking, minor extra, some details are added and you are good to go. So definitely focus on the basics. You can go for the advanced topics like which are in basically the module 5 and 6, and later on you can, for the initial stages, you can definitely not put much focus on 2, 3, 4 modules are important. You don't need to basically, let's say if you are doing a topic, there is absolutely no need to fully complete the topic. You are not able to solve the hard questions, you can leave that for now, but at least focus on the medium questions. There's no need to complete 100% of that. First step is complete the basics, then only move to the advanced fundamental topic. Yeah.
All right. So just in maybe a couple of words, what will be your key to, you know, being consistent and, you know, studying every day?
I would say you have to love coding. If you don't love coding, you'll have to force yourself to love coding. Okay. I would definitely say that. Uh-huh. So I know it can be challenging at times, but you have to realize that ultimately you will have to study, whether now or whether after job. So you'll have to study and it's totally fine. You are doing DSA, you're sharpening your brain. That is, it's not like DSA is useless. Definitely DSA will be used. I got asked a few questions, be it simple, but still I was asked a few questions in the interview. So in job also, it's been a month that I have joined. So in job also, sometimes the DSA is used. Sometimes there are situations I'm only able to solve because I did DSA in Programming Pathshala. So definitely DSA is helpful.
Absolutely. DSA is going to help you anytime. Even like after 3 to 4 years, you want to switch, you will have to come back to the basics, you know. Yeah, absolutely.
It's a good thing that I have done my part right now. So after 3-4 years, let's say, I'll just have to revise and not study from DSA from the scratch. There are people who have like 3-4 years of experience and still stuck at arrays and dynamic arrays. I've seen such people.
Understood. Got it. So for my last question, Bikramjeet, what is, you know, the entire highlight for you starting, you know, from your switching to, you know, realizing that you want to go into the tech side, coming to Programming Pathshala, preparing, getting a job, now start, you've already working there for more than a month, I'm guessing now.
Yes.
So now when you look back, it's a long, long journey. What is the highlight for you?
See, the highlight for me is that I have done my part. I'm still a fresher. So I have a long journey to complete as of now. So the highlight for me, for anybody who is watching this interview, I would say is that be consistent. even if you are doing one question at one or two questions a day, that is still consistent, I would say. There is absolutely, it's not like, it's just like gymming, okay? It's not like 5 days you are not working out or, and on Saturday, Sunday, you cannot do 6-7 hours of gymming, okay? So brain is all, treat your brain also like a muscle. So go slow, but be consistent. Don't go that slow just like me. 6 months to 1 year, 1 year max you should take. I think 16, 17, 18,000 points should be more than enough to start your journey as a software development engineer.
Got
that
it.
Is what I would say.
All right. Thank you so much for your time and interviewing with us today.
Thank you, Gloria. Lovely talking to you.
Yes. And congratulations again from the entire Programming Pathshala team. And really proud of, you know, how you continue to be, I mean, being consistent, which was key. And I think it's a really nice story when, you know, people from other non-software engineering backgrounds who want to do it, yeah, and, you know, who keep working hard and, you know, crack that. It's a big success, yes, for us as well. So yes, thank you for being part of that story for us.
Thank you. Thank you. One thing I would like to say, that Programming Pathshala came to my life when I was absolutely hopeless from each and every end. So you never know, this can be a turning point for you as well.
All right. Thank you.
Always be hopeful. Thank you, Glory. Thank you. Thank you.